Today's the last full day to do a number of things before they scale back or shut down altogether for the next 4 weeks. Restrictions go into effect at 11:59 tonight and include social gathering with other households, dining at restaurants, adult and youth sports, and going to the gym. You can find the full list, including what will remain open, on care11.com.
And Minnesotans donated more than $30 million to local nonprofits and schools for Give to the Max Day.
And here's a look at your 7-day forecast. Today, 42, cooler, 41 come tomorrow with a rain snow mix Sunday morning. 38 by Monday, another shot at rain and snow come Tuesday. And hey, look at Thanksgiving. Things look pretty quiet with a high of 42, and we'll see some sunshine. That should be nice.
And the morning commute's looking pretty nice as well. There's been no crashes or delays. So if you're about to head out the door, don't have to rush out the door, that is. There's, like I said, no crashes or delays for this Friday morning commute.
Perfect. And we are on Facebook.
Happy Friday morning.
Woo, yes. We made it.
End of the
Finally.
Week.
Finally.
Always a happy day for us in here after another tough week indeed. Oh, boy. Hey, we have some good news. I know the lockdowns are going in effect, or lockdowns, or, you know, the pause, what we're calling it, at 11:59 tonight. But we have some good news to start off with, because we have breaking news. Pfizer is actually going to ask U.S. regulators today for emergency use authorization of its COVID-19 vaccine. Now, this is a vaccine the company said was 95% effective against the virus. The request could make limited shots available as early as next month. So that's something to look forward to.
This is a big deal, because it also could mean the end of this pandemic coming in the near future. So we'll be following that for you this morning.
Some doctors say if this is approved and they can start giving these emergency doses out next month, that widespread vaccinations could be available in April. Of course, that all depends on manufacturing. They've got to get hundreds of millions of these doses available. So let's hope, two things, it's approved, and number two, that it is 95% effective.
And then shortly after, I imagine some of the other vaccines will be on this route as well. So all good news there. But we've also got to talk about the CDC's warning, though, for Thanksgiving, because that is next week. We're less than 1 week away, and the CDC is saying stay home this Thanksgiving. So, Alicia, you were talking about this morning.
Yeah, you know, I had a Twitter poll, you guys, up saying that the CDC says it's not worth it, that the folks should cancel their big holiday plans if they did have them still planned for next Thursday. And we're almost nearing 500 votes this morning. Only 55% saying yes, that they did change their plans last minute here to coincide with what the CDC is recommending for folks. But a lot of course, as it's 55, it's almost 50-50. So of course, there's mixed reaction to this news from the CDC and from our viewers this morning.
50-50. That kind of surprised me. I thought more people would change their plans.
Yeah, I mean, I'm curious to know what's going to actually happen on the day if people do, you know, decide to not go see mom or dad or their other relatives. But yeah, the CDC is saying only your immediate household. So we asked our Sunrisers this morning for comments too, as well as Alicia's poll. So this person's saying Thanksgiving, we are keeping Thanksgiving small this year. Just my wife and three sons and my sister and her son. It's far smaller than the 30 plus they usually have. Wow. That's Paul.
Yeah, that's amazing. 30 plus. Thanksgiving on the farm in the heated shop. Tables spaced out, and after dinner, some good hunting and splitting wood for the wood stove. That's all a busy Thanksgiving.
Yeah, this person is saying no, because I have the sense to stay home and watch planes, trains, and automobiles alone without being prodded to by the CDC. Okay.
Never seen it.
Neither.
Sorry, but we're having a big gathering of people who are out of quarantine after all testing positive. It's celebration time. Restrictions aren't stopping us.
Whoa.
Not sure if that's tongue-in-cheek or if that's actually true.
Yeah, well, if it's true, it's a bad idea, I would say. All right, this person says, based on descriptions of the hospitals from our healthcare worker friends, we decided to forego an outdoors Thanksgiving with my cousin's family. I believe we need to do this to keep others safe and alive. This is Anne from Minneapolis. Yeah, not even doing an outdoor Thanksgiving.
Yeah, so a lot of people changing their plans. Guy, did you have to change your plans, or are you going to do it pretty low-key yourself anyway?
Yeah, we were low-key to start off with, so no change in my plans here.
Now, Alicia, you made some changes to yours, did you not?
Yeah, you know, a few weeks back, the governor has said that it could be 10 people max, which is what mine was. But then we just kind of talked about it. I've been in contact with someone with COVID. So just to be extra safe at Willanow, of course, the CDC and our local health officials are saying, you know, stay home, keep it within your household. And you know what? I'd rather see my family next Thanksgiving, hopefully maybe even New Year's, who knows, instead of infect maybe some folks in my family. Gotta be safe. So we're gonna do a virtual Turkey Day bingo and get our drink on.
Oh, virtual bingo. That's nice. So yourself,
Gia? That's fun. I have two people on my list. It's Jordan, my partner, and then Teddy.
Teddy
that
the dog.
That's it. My dad was like, hey, maybe don't come by. And I was like,
Teddy.
Whew. Thank you, Dad.
Teddy's going to get some good leftovers. Yeah. That's excellent. Yeah, I'm doing a low-key one, too. I mean, it's going to be upsetting for a lot of people. They can't get drunk and get in arguments with their family members in person. They'll have to do it over Zoom, perhaps.
Exactly.
Are you guys still eating turkey?
I, for one, will not eat turkey. I'm not the biggest turkey fan to begin with. And so if it's just a small Thanksgiving, there's no reason to make a big turkey. Yeah. I mean, they all seem big if there's only two people, right? Yeah. So I'm doing something else.
Jordan and I said rotisserie chicken. What did you say, Guy?
You know, I'll be definitely doing the turkey.
Okay.
Alicia, will you be cooking turkey?
I am not. You know what? I donated my turkey, so I am going to order from a restaurant, maybe get some, like, Chinese takeout. Mix it up. It's 2020.
Yeah. Right.
There you go.
Exactly.
Very, very living on the edge here. All right, let's get to those restrictions.
For sure.
In effect, 11:59.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so Minnesota turns back the dial for 4 weeks, as we had mentioned a couple days ago. Our hospitals, healthcare workers are getting slammed by this coronavirus outbreak. So restaurants, bars, gyms are getting the brunt of these new restrictions. They're asking restaurants to no more indoor dining. Gyms are going to have to close. So we asked our Sunrisers how they're going to use this time to work together and get this thing under control.
Yeah, we needed some hints. Mm-hmm. So hopefully we got a few good responses here. Let's see what they said. I know I'm going out for dinner and to the gym today, so I'm going to try to fit in as much as possible.
I know. I was telling Chris that I've been going to the gym all week in anticipation of these new restrictions. But yeah, some more Sunrisers weighing in. Try not to get sick and keep sane.
Let's hope the sanity thing keeps. Greg says, same as for the last 4 weeks and the 4 weeks before that and the 4 weeks before that. Stay home and try not to get sick. Order stuff online and pretend the zombie apocalypse affects everything but delivery service.
I like that. I think Greg might be a Walking Dead fan like me. Johnny says, already booked tickets to see the lights at the state fairgrounds and the Minnesota Zoo. Plan to do Zoom chats with family and friends. Play family games, watch sports, drink adult beverages, stay home for stress-free holiday.
That sounds fun.
There's a lot to do. Good ideas, Johnny. Good ideas. We have Zico.
Good idea.
Saying, when I get cabin fever, I plan on going to state parks if the weather is nice. If it is too cold, going for a drive to look at Christmas lights. To fight boredom, video games and online shopping.
Not bad.
Yeah, the state parks right now are pretty empty since the weather is a little colder now. So that's a good place to go. Same advice as I've used the last number of weeks, months. Or done, probably. The whole deal started. Mass up, go out when needed. You know, do all that stuff. Cook.
Yeah, cook, exactly. So there are some options, so it's not all so bad. Let's hope it's just for the 4 weeks, and then we can get things back to normal if we manage to curb the current trend where we see the upward cases going. All right, Guy, we are going into that weekend with the restrictions in place. Hopefully it'll be a nice one. We can all get outside.
Yeah, I think we'll be able to get outside. We'll just have to, you know, bust out the coats. But temperatures won't be too cold, or at least afternoon high temperatures won't be too cold, that is. We'll start off the morning with some low lows, chilly lows. But other than that, things pretty seasonal and quiet. Now, we do have a disturbance on late Saturday night. Most of us probably sleep by the time it starts moving through wee hours of the morning. Sunday, snow to rain by Sunday late day, building sun. So a quick mover. Monday, we're quiet. Tuesday, a little bit of the same thing with a wintry mix possible. And then after that, quiet 44, warmest day on the 7th. Thanksgiving looks nice and quiet with 42, seeing some sunshine.
That's not a bad forecast for this time of year.
Lovely, lovely. All right.
Not bad.
Friday, the week has come to an end for us.
Woo!
All right, enjoy your days off.
Bye.
We'll be back Monday.
Take care.